Recently, within the last couple weeks, Marshall Headphones released the Emberton Bluetooth speaker, and being kind of a fan of Zound Industries and the Marshall speakers that they make, I figured it was worth trying to check it out and compare it to the Marshall Kilburn 2 and the Stockwell 2. So first of all, let's talk about build quality before we go into sound. I love the way most all Marshall speakers feel, sound, and are constructed. And these are all pretty nice. Though I would hand it to the Stockwell 2, that's probably the best looking of the bunch. Just like the gold and the little handle. Also that like gold felt underneath is just beautiful. And those knobs are great. And the Kilburn 2 is really pretty. It's got that weird blue plasticky pleather material, but it doesn't feel like plastic. And then you've got the Emberton, which... it's honestly kind of the ugliest one of the bunch, to be honest. It doesn't have much dialing. But honestly, after reviewing it, I found that it's actually the most functional one of all. The new gold interface button they put on there allows you to fast forward, pause, control, turn up and down your volume directly on the device versus having to go on your phone, which is a huge pain in the butt. Especially if you're like at a party, you don't want to be the person with the phone that has total control. I mean, I guess that could be a good thing if you're playing good music, but what if you're not playing good music and people want to turn it off? But anyways, let's talk about the other thing, waterproofing. The Emberton has an IPX rating of 7, which is like you can put it under like a meter of water for up to 30 minutes. So you want to take a bath with it, you can do that. The Stockwell has an IPX of 4 and the Kilburn has like a 2, so not quite as much. And it probably is kind of expensive to make these things waterproof. Not going to lie, gaskets and stuff are not cheap. All right, let's do sound quality now. So I actually had two setups, an interior sound check, and then an exterior sound check. And then at the end, I'll give you my own subjective opinion about which I think is better. Yep, so you're hearing it there. The Emberton and the Stockwell are both at full volume, and then the Kilburn and the Rallis are turned down like 70%. The Emberton, to my ear, started sounding quite a bit clearer than the others, a lot less muddy. Okay, I'm gonna try these all out. God, that's loud. Portable speaker for just fun. It sounds more boomy. It's just to be expected. Sounds a lot muddier, like scrambled eggs. cat's probably pissed off. That's at max volume too. Bass is a little bit more together than it is on the Rallis. Yep. Ooh, that sounds terrible. Oh God. Sorry, that's my initial reaction. It just sounds, it sounds awful compared to the rest of them. It's all looks. It's just paltry in comparison. It's just not pushing up enough volume at all. It's definitely got a much brighter mid to high frequency, but it doesn't sound bad. Like, it sounds pretty good. For as small as that is, it's just a better speaker. Yeah. Like, let's sing. Has got a ton of sound. One thing I will say about the Emberton, its one flaw is this. When you turn it on, it makes this really cringy noise. After playing all the speakers inside and outside, I'd have to say I think the Emberton is probably the best buy. For the size, it sounds significantly better than the Stockwell 2. Honestly, the Kilburn 2 doesn't sound quite as good as the Rallis, which I don't even know if they make it anymore, but it's from the same Zound Industries. I think it has sometimes a little bit better bass in certain areas, but overall it's just not as together. It sounds a bit clumsier. So I'd say for looks, Stockwell and the Kilburn 2 are probably your best looking speakers, but in terms of quality of sound, the Emberton and the Rallis are probably the best. So worth $150?
Yeah.
It's definitely like, seems like a roadworthy companion. And it sounds good. Like, the music seems to retain most of its, like, really good qualities. Yeah, you're not going to get quite as much bass as, like, these bigger guys, but I don't know. It seems to translate the music in a way that is pleasing to me and, like, seems accurate, and I feel like I can really hear what's going on. When it sounds muddy, like the Kilburn does, or especially the Stockwell too, it just doesn't really do it for me. I don't know. It's all looks. I wish it sounded as good as it looked, because then it would sound amazing, but honestly, the Emberton has it beat. So, some quick gripes about the other speakers. The Stockwell, it doesn't actually start playing music until you pump it up to about 8. Everything below the volume of 8 is like dead silent, and it's only till you get to 8 and above that it actually like sounds loud enough, and just barely at that. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. So go out and buy one, I guess. Cool, thanks for watching.